Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Danny, and I'm here with Kesha to talk about Salary Overflow. Welcome to the show, Kesha.
Hi, Danny. It's great to be here.
Can you tell me a little bit more about Salary Overflow?
Sure. So when you hear the term Salary Overflow, think Stack Overflow, but for salaries. I created Salary Overflow to bring transparency to tech salaries with the overall goal of hoping to reduce the gender pay gap and give people, especially women, the data they need to help negotiate their salaries.
Okay, so I'm a user of this new application. Can you tell me what happens first?
Sure. So you go to salaryoverflow.com and you're met with a login screen that is served up from S3 to CloudFront to your browser.
Excellent. So now I assume I have to log in.
Yes.
To see the data.
Yes.
How does that happen?
So you're met with a login screen and I use Cognito user pools as the authentication piece for my web application. If you are a new user, the very first time you log in, Cognito will trigger a Lambda, and that Lambda then enters data, the new user record, into the Aurora MySQL database.
So I see that you're using Aurora here. Why did you choose Aurora?
Right, so when I started thinking about the design for this system, I had two options. I had DynamoDB, NoSQL, and I had Aurora. And I decided to use Aurora because my data is relational.
Okay, so now we're gonna pull this data back and show it to the user. How does that happen?
Yes, so I use, for the API layer, I use GraphQL. And so from the website, I use GraphQL APIs to communicate with the data to either retrieve it or update it.
Why did you choose GraphQL?
Well, with GraphQL, I have experience working with REST APIs, and that is very rigid. So for example, when you first create a REST API, if you're bringing back five elements, you get five elements back each time you call the API. With GraphQL and AppSync, I have the flexibility to only query for what I need and bring back exactly what I need. And that may change with a different screen. So it offers a lot of flexibility.
Do you do any user tracking?
Yes, so I use Pinpoint, it's up here, for metrics. So I'm able to track user sessions and authentication.
And I see this is a serverless architecture. Did you use any frameworks to help you build it?
Yes, I used Amplify. So AWS Amplify is a tool that really helped me stand up the majority of these components in about 2.5 weeks.
Wow, that's fast.
Yes, rapid delivery.
Can you tell me about some future plans you have for this architecture?
Yes, so I released Salary Overflow about a month ago, and I have right now close to 2,000 signups. Once I reach 5,000, I'm going to integrate Amazon SageMaker and machine learning models that I will use to make salary predictions and really give people like hard data that they can use to help negotiate their salary.
Can you tell me about your release pipeline?
Sure. Out of the box, AWS Amplify comes with a CI/CD pipeline built in, and it really allows me to scale the development team. So there are feature branches in my version control that map nicely to the AWS Amplify backend portion. So I have a prod environment, a dev environment, and a test environment. And as I merge or move changes from development, and I check them into a certain branch, it automatically deploys. And I got all of that out of the box.
This is a really important project. Salary transparency is important in negotiations. I'd like to thank you for building this application and for sharing your architecture with us today. And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.